Nico is very strong against AP Cannon, so it's a very good top lane matchup for the Nico. It was seen as a counter pick and was brought out when Nico was starting to kind of flirt with relevance when it
feels
comes
like
to the pro level.
Cannon, right?
But it's also the safer blind lane, mid lane champion.
In order to lock down the CC, as Faker moves onto the bottom side, Loken caught out of position. The arcane shift has been used. Flash still available, uses it to get out of the way.
Not going to be there as cleared.
Volatile Spiderling comes down. He's looking for the cocoon. Does thread the needle with the arcane shift, was buffered. Clint still looking for this damage. Repel is still available. Marta's going to flash. He had turret aggro, but now top esports are converging. XX wants the body slam as Faker is down here. You and me in, but not going to find it. There's the slicing maelstrom, but just destroyed. Khan will get himself the reset on the World Ender, but they straight up don't need it. Marta just
still
tanked.
Going aggressive. Aftershock doing work. Meanwhile, there's a dive on the top side. Flash from Moyu, but he's running the wrong way. Faker comes around.
Plank is in motion,
position.
Though.
Okay, the back does come in, and God, SXX taking way too much damage. There's the maelstrom, but Moyu, we've seen this one before. He just gets obliterated. The cast he's going on deaf ears right now. It's Khan. World Ender. This might be a little bit of a mistake here as far as positioning. Fate's call comes down. There we go, Pop Blossom. On the two people, Faker starting off the fight. And he may just end it as well. Two for one so far, as Moyu did at least get a kill.
There's the Faker playmaker.
Khan, down towards the bottom side, or should I say Faker? As now cleared, it's going to be a 50-50, and it's taken by Top Esports. The repel used immediately. True Shot Barrage.
Yeah, opportunities available. Boy. Teddy moving on over. Fate's Call not going to be really an opportunity unless he can get in there.
Does have to use the stopwatch. Final Chapter getting some value this time as Faker's Pop Blossom only works onto Moyu. Faker has to go. Golden flashes immediately. Cocoon lands onto Knight. The dredge line out of nowhere and cleared. Secures the kill, but Loken is getting so much damage. Picks up the kill on the support, and now Faker wants to find it. The Blooming Burst, not enough, and Loken, the hero for China, even though he's Korean.
Oh, wait a minute.
Oh, Teddy, looking for the turnaround.
Mid lane.
Well, all five members of top are here. A lot of damage actually in response, but Khan has a flank opportunity. Good knock-up, but Knight's just dived onto him. Infernal Chain's not actually going to work as Khan able to Umbral Dash to get himself out of the way, but Flash was invested, and he'll now need to teleport to get back forward. Faker finds three with the Pop Blossom out of absolutely nowhere. Final Chapter is in, though. Top able to answer one back, as this is not over yet. Loken over the wall, but into the open arms of the Itsy Bitsy Spider, who's not so Itsy Bitsy right now. Double kill comes down for Clid, and now Knight Nine try and get himself out of the way. Ben is on there as well, trying to be a hero here for his carry. The You and Me is beautiful to try and help this one, but we got the zoom in. That's a yes, you can, as the double kill comes through for the
SKT, and the LCK are going to go up 2-0, and it's going to have to be a reverse sweep to stop them finally winning their first Rift Rivals.
The story at the beginning of this tournament wasn't about the veterans, but so far this series, it certainly has been. First Death, like you say, then Faker winning the game off the back of that Pop Blossom.